Hello YouTube, my name is Shruti and you're watching Tickle Me Pink. Now, if you've given a board exam this year, whether 10th or 12th, your results have A, either already been declared, or B, they're on their way, like they're going to be declared soon. So I just thought I'd make a video talking about results and telling you guys that in the long run, it all doesn't really matter. So if you like this video, then please do subscribe to my channel and follow me on all my social media to be updated with my video upload schedule. And now, let's get started. So the first thing that I want to talk about are those really annoying relatives who you haven't spoken to in probably like 5 or 10 years, who randomly pop up at the time of your results to ask you, "Beta, marks kitne mile?" Please, 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 please understand that these adults do not matter whatsoever. Like, what they think doesn't matter, what they say doesn't matter, and what they do doesn't matter. Because clearly, first of all, they don't care about you. They don't have your best intentions at heart, because if they did, they would have turned up when you won that very important sports tournament. Or they would have turned up when you won that really cool award in your school. Or they would have turned up when you were sick for 5 days in the 9th standard. But they didn't show up for any of those big moments in your life, so they don't deserve to be a part of this moment. Speaking about family, the second thing that I want to talk about is your parents. Trust me, they are going to love you and they are going to care about you no matter what. Yes, there might be a little drama for a few days if you haven't lived up to their expectations in terms of marks. They might be a little disappointed, but no matter what happens, they are still going to be your parents and they are still going to absolutely cherish the floor that you walk on, because you're their kid and nothing is going to change that. No marks, no grades, absolutely nothing is going to change that fact, and they are going to love and care about you and adore you for the rest of your life, whether you like it or not. The third thing that I want to talk about is to not let your marks and grades dictate what you want to do in life. You do what you want to do. Like, don't let your marks or your parents or society or your friends tell you what you should be pursuing in your life, because trust me, if you go down that road, it only ends in frustration and you absolutely hating all your life decisions. I speak from personal experience because I did that. Now, since I was in the first standard, I loved writing. Like, I remember the first like chapter book that I wrote was when I was 6 or 7 years old. And I knew somewhere like in my gut that that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to create stories. I wanted to maybe write a book one day. Like, that was my dream since I was probably 7 or 8 years old. But somewhere along the way, I guess because, I don't know, because of society, because of the things my friends were doing, I forgot about that dream. And I remember after my 10th standard board exam, when I had to go into junior college and decide whether I wanted to take up science, commerce, or arts, because all my friends were taking up science and because like I had good enough marks to get into a good enough college and take up science, I did that. Like, somewhere like in my gut, I knew I should have taken up arts and pursued my dream of becoming a journalist or a writer or something in the creative space. But I don't know, like peer pressure, society pressure, everything forced me to take up science. And if I had just had the guts to listen to myself and listen to what my heart and my gut was telling me to do at the age of 16, I would have been on the path of pursuing my dream and doing something that made me happy a lot earlier in my life. So seriously, don't let these marks or what your parents say or what your friends are doing, don't let any of that hold you back from pursuing what you really feel like doing. Because trust me, if you really want to do something, you will find a way to do it. And even if you feel like you don't have enough marks to get into the best college for your dream course or whatever right now, it's okay. Maybe you go to a college that's not the best, but work really, really, really damn hard in that college to finally achieve what you want to do. Because honestly, you guys are just 16, 17, and 18 years old. And I know that maybe at this time you feel like you're all grown up and you're adults and you're ready to conquer the world, but You guys are just starting out. Like, I know you might not want to hear this, but that is my point number four, which is that you have a long way to go ahead of you. You guys have your entire life ahead of you, and that life is filled with endless possibilities, and it's going to be filled with more successes, maybe more failures. It's going to be filled with ups and downs and twists and turns, and it's just going to be absolutely crazy. But that's the beauty of it. It's just that you guys have so much ahead of you that these marks, whatever you've received in your 10th, 12th, whatever, is not the end. It in fact is just the beginning to a really crazy roller coaster of a life ahead of you. If you've got your marks and you've done really, really well, then that's great. You guys should totally embrace this moment, enjoy yourself and celebrate, because I mean, you've earned it. But just remember, don't become complacent. Use this feeling of euphoria that you have right now to work even harder and more to achieve that dream that you've set for yourself. Or on the other hand, if you've not done as well as you hope to, then that's also okay, because trust me, you have your entire life ahead of you and this is just the beginning. These marks do not define how successful you are going to become in life. So it's okay, just buck up. Forget about this tiny spot of failure that might have happened in your life and find another way, find another route, and just work really, really, really hard to achieve your dream. So yeah, I'm going to leave it at that. I hope this video helped you in any way. If you have any questions, you can drop them down in the comments and I'll try to reply to them to the best of my abilities, or maybe other people who watch this video can help you out in some way. And of course, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for weekly fashion and lifestyle videos. Bye!